श्रीमती रामानुजा नमः। It is unanimously accepted by philosophy or theosophy or anthroposophy that ignorance is the root of all evils and wisdom is the solution. Science is the process by which that wisdom is aimed at. As there are innumerable dimensions with innumerable depths and various divisions, the pursuit of impeccable knowledge that is also untiring, perpetual. In the field of science, now we have come to the crown of science, the triad, that is the systemics, cybernetics and informatics. If the wisdom is personified as a jewel and there are innumerable ornaments, we can clearly explain and establish the concept that this triad is the crown of everything, that also makes the rule of wisdom to be well established in a perfect throne with a precise scepter. I want to establish this by taking into account the ontophilosophical status of systems of reality of our traditional wisdom, in which we say there is tattva, there is sambandha and vyavahara. Tattva is reality or real substance, which we call as a system. A system is defined as a conglomeration of various organs which have been binded inside a compound for a common purpose, for a directed action. So that is the system, that is reality or tattva. Second is sambandha, the mutual behavioral interaction as well as the interface that exists between two things for mutual communication and productive end, that is known as cybernetics or sambandha, and by which this knowledge or this system which we call as information, a productive signal, is transferred, transmitted, revealed, delivered by multimodular analytical beings which we call as informatics. So tattva, sambandha and vyavahara is systemics, cybernetics and informatics that basically forms the ground of all philosophical existences and elucidations. And now we have to stop with the systems, because we know that the world is comprised of innumerable systems, living systems, natural systems, developed systems, modified systems, emerging systems, obsolete systems, novel systems, futuristic systems, innumerable divisions of systems used to have. Each and every part and particle of this world is nothing but a system. And they act in two major ways. One, they exist as a separate system with separate behavior. They also have innumerable systems which are known as embedded systems inside, which forms as a compound for multiple functioning. Number three, it serves as a component for some other compound for a common and directed principle and action. So these things are very philosophical in nature. Basically, coming into the brain section or the most sensational section of this triad science, that is cybernetics, there is a basic explanation. There is a normal explanation. There is a fundamental explanation. There is a theoretical explanation. There is extensive explanation. There is expressive explanation. And there is a metaphysical and metaphorical explanations for each and every term. But basically, cybernetics, they used to define it as study of the structure of regulatory systems. The system which is based on regulation. What is regulation? Regulation of action and benefit end is known as perfection. Regulation of the end of any function is known as precision. Regulation of time is known as punctuality. So these things are time basis, then end basis, action basis, process basis, base basis. All of these various things, they form a regulatory system. The system which has a base, a process, an end, which is recycled into the same base, which is a perpetual, never-ending way of functioning. It is known as anavastha. It is infinite as well as it is perpetual. And these things are known as regulatory systems. Basically, this science is based on two major theories. One is tattva vijnana, second is niyati or niyama vijnana. Tattva vijnana is known as systems theory, and niyati vijnana, niyama vijnana is known as control theory. Control theory is based on dynamic systems, I've already told it must have some regulation. In dynamic systems, where there is dynamism, dynamism is effective action directed by a force moving towards a goal. In all dynamic systems, the output is scientifically defined as a reference. There must be a controller, either mechanical, metamechanical, mega-mechanical or mechanical, there must be a controller. And the controller should manipulate the input and adjust to such a level that he is getting the desired output, just as we are having in machines and automobiles. So based on these things, the controller system is that which manipulates the input as per the desired output. It may be homogenetic or heterogenetic, it may be a closed loop or open loop controller system. Yes. This is the basic of control, which is there in all living beings, all non-living beings, all forces, or any other such fusions, fissions, and various other hybridizations that we are yet to perform. This is a common rule which is unerasable, indelible in the mark of nature's imprint. So nobody can move from these things. So this control is based on various levels: adaptative, hierarchic, optimal, then intelligent oriented, robust, then trim and response systems, in which a set point is with a lot of reset sequences, that is trim and respond. There are innumerable things like stochastic control is there in modern machines. This is known as the control system. And now we are going to deal with the second system. Why I am saying is, even to realize God, there must be a system knowledge and control knowledge. In yoga, mysticism, in Vedanta, philosophy, in livelihood, jivana, in vijnana, science, in samaja, society, this is the basic concept of understanding the controller systems, which has made cybernetics to give a universal status that encompasses and embraces all divisions of knowledge. That is the greatness of these things. So all these various divisions of control has made the persons to understand control with various things. One is nature, second is man, and third is machine. It has created a trilateral way of understanding the diversifying factors in these three major entities. What is systems theory? It is understanding the complex systems. There are different types of systems: intricate system, intrigue system, obscure system, abysmal system, innate system, exocentric system, endocentric system, polycentric system, multicentric system. Innumerable systems are there. Complex systems are intricacy and complexity with the different subtle structural and functional behavior of embedded innumerable parts that comprise that particular status. A system consists of innumerable inner parts and divisions. Each of every particle or each and every atomic structure of its innate nature being different, distinguishable, distinct, as well as being presented in such an integrated and complex stage, so that it requires more attention, more study, deeper experience, and repetitive trials for understanding these things. They are known as complex materials. So understanding the complex systems of nature, of machine and society is known as systems theory. Now there is a basic system theory by which there is system inquiry. How to get into system inquiry as per the ancient as well as the modern system? They are having no difference at all. There is no cleavage between modern and ancient systems in understanding this principle. For example, there is the very famous theory of von Bertalanffy. This Bertalanffy theory that deals with first philosophy, understanding philosophy, then science, then technology. To understand about any concept, that's what we used to say, for everything there is perception. For assuring your perception, there is your inference. For assuring your perception and inference, there is your experience. For assuring your experience, there is science. For assurance of science, there is mathematics. For assurance of mathematics, there is logic. For assurance of logic, there is philosophy. For assurance of philosophy, there is self-realization. For assurance of the fullest self-realization, there is liberation, emancipation, and salvation, which we call vimukti, which is the ad infinitum and ultimatum in our systems of thought. So this is the hierarchy of understandings. So they call from philosophy, first to philosophical understanding of principles, concepts, and functions, which will lead you to science, and science leads you to engineered tools and devices and apply it in the form of technology. Second thing, there is a B.M. Benathy system of thought, where they start with philosophy, then it deals with concepts and principles in the form of theory, then it deals with methodology, then deals with application. Philosophy means somebody should not think that closing your eyes are going to forest, are leaving all of your relations, are totally renouncing your wealth. These things are one dimension of philosophy. The same philosophy which makes you to lose your wealth, it also gives way for an effective wealth, productive wealth, harmless wealth in the society. The same thing which detaches you from the society gives you reasonable, multi-embraceable attachment with the members of society, resulting in peace and harmony. The same thing which asks you to close your eyes, that also opens your inner eye. The same thing which drives you to the forest, that will make you to see that the society will not become a forest, and even forest is totally taken care so that it is not being afforested. So this type of potential and dynamic dimensions of applied philosophy or theodynamics, that clearly that gives us the idea how to deal with the real effect of science. So he called philosophy as first axiology, then epistemology, ontology with teleology, agathology and other subsciences. The second thing is he deals with the concepts and principles in the form of theories. Third thing is to design and model the tools of methods. Fourth is application that deals with usage and interaction. This was the ancient system which has continued even now. Then coming to cybernetics, cybernetics, it deals with two major forces. The forces are intra-relative and inter-relative. Intra-relative force within your system is known as force of control. Inter-relative force within the society is known as communication. So the science that deals with the intra-relative and inter-relative forces, which are known as control and communication, that is known as cybernetics, and that deals with all the complex systems and also the study of four things. One is gati or process, how this control and communication that happens. And second thing is reaction or phala or impact, what impact it creates in the society. Then third thing is vipratipatti, that is change, how it can be changed. That is the fourth thing known as modification, which is niyantrana. So it deals how the process of control and transformation happens in the society, what is the reaction of this control as well as the communication transformation, what are the changes that occur, what are the proportionate possibilities of modification in these various things, what are the changes that occur naturally, how we can bring changes for effective ruling. These things are the four pillars of cybernetics. Now we are in the fourth pillar. We have understood how it behaves, how it reacts, and what are the natural changes. Now the intrusion possibility of human knowledge in the form of science and technology can be augmented, can we make it more productive, can we mitigate, can we suppress, can we oppress, can we boost, can we instigate, can we nullify, all of these various intrusion possibilities into the cybernetic forces for the welfare of the society, mankind, in increasing the progeny, increasing the longevity, in increasing the health and aging, in increasing everything except happiness and harmony. Everything is taken care in modern cybernetics. So it is something to deal with man-machine instincts. So it has nothing to do with the ethical base, that is the problem. Now there is also ethical cybernetics which we have to bring now. So this is what we call the basic cybernetics. Cybernetics is based on three major principles. Without understanding which, why I am saying this is, if that is a basic study, now what we are going to do here is to explain the real pathway of understanding science. For example, there was a story of Chanakya. When Chanakya attacked the direct center of a kingdom, he could not attack and he could not gain his triumph, so he was badly defeated. He was consuming round dosa at one village. It is just a story. Immediately he was there to take the center portion of the dosa to eat. It was so hot. Then that old lady, she advised, you have to take care of the surroundings. Gradually when you are consuming, the thing will be cooler, then you can approach the center. With that very small edible ethics, he has understood how to attack, he has understood the defense mechanism, and he attacked like that. Now, we are not understanding science because we are not understanding systemic cybernetics and informatics. Now we have taken a reverse way of apprehension or reverse way of comprehension. After knowing everything, gradually we have come to this triad. If you would have taken the lead by this triad, certainly you would have arrived at more harmless, more effective, more fruitful, and more deeper dimensions. Now also, keeping this as an axis, nucleus, hub, and pivotal standard and the style of understanding must be given to these three major principles, based on which if you read anything, biology, geology, ontology, then information technology, computer sciences, biomedical engineering, astronomy, astrophysics, terrestrial physics, geology, geostatistics, hydrostatistics, thermodynamics, innumerable, whatever it may be. If you understand from these three principles, you can have a deeper knowledge, and you have to throw more lights through such conferences. So, first is system dynamics. These things are the three major eyes of the cybernetics. First is system dynamics. Second thing is engineering psychology. And third thing is metasystem, study of metasystem. The first thing, system dynamics, that deals with the dynamic operations of the system on the basis of which there is the chaos theory, etc. Chaos theory that deals with the deterministic behavior of a particle or a system, wherein by there is a dynamic resistance towards its initial conditions, where there is a possible deviation of its deterministic nature, resulting in probabilistic nature or random motion. This is known as chaos theory. This is the base of whole universal functions. So on the basis of this theory only, this dynamism is being read by most of the people and analyzed also. So second thing is engineering psychology. Like as J.B. Forrester, he was a very great analyst who interpreted the system dynamics and chaos theory as per the Vedic Sankhya philosophy. And the other thing is, now we are going to deal with engineering psychology, like Humberto Maturana. They are great biologists, and they derive the principle of studying behavior and experience in complex systems. What is the behavior in complex system? Intentional behavior, and also the experience. The impact of other things on them is known as experience. That things on other is known as behavior. Behavior is an external output, and experience is an input given by the ego sources. So this is being read by the people, by which the emotional, basic, rudimentary, motivistic, then sensational, intellectual, bio-intellectual, psycho-intellectual, psychological, acceptical, then affective, cognitive, various other impacts of the mind and its mysteries have been revealed in this science. Now we are coming to metasystems. Just as we call grandfather the father of father, the system of system, now they are researching on cybernetics of cybernetics. The systems of system, if there is a system, there must be a seed for a tree which has given once more a seed. Likewise, there must be a system for a system. That system is known as metasystem. We have a metasystem in economics, in mathematics there is a metasystem. In biology we have, in psychology we have metasystems. We have metasystems in all parts of education. Even in now we have meta-languages, which is known as a very great tackling problem in computer science. It is known as handling and tackling problem in modern computer science. Wherein by they say that while language is inadequate, we need a larger context than the language's apprehension or language's applicability or accessibility. We need something more than a language, and that is known as meta-language. Likewise, we are having metasystems engineering. If somebody is going to read, somebody if they say, I am reading MBS, that is, I am just mastering my Masters of Science in metasystems engineering, then there is a growth of innovative sciences. Metasystem engineering, then metasystem transition, and there is also one more system which is antipoietic reflexive system theory. It is reflexive, yes, allopoietic is also there, and autopoietic and allopoietic is also there. So there are two divisions in that. And reflexive, autopoietic, reflection theory, and transition theory of these metasystems, as well as research into various other combinations of engineering meta devices and metasystems that is there in the modern trend. Apart from which, now we are coming into the real study of the historical pursuit of cybernetics and philosophical study of cybernetics also. The first thing is, you know that cybernetics is started as a small worm. It started as a small microbe. They just call it as some signs of control and communication alone. The theories of Norbert Wiedemann, first recently they started as just it is simple control and communication system. Then second it came into Stafford Beer's theory, when he defined it as effective system of organization. That is Stafford Beer's theory, where he said that it is effective organization. Effective organization is a very wonderful word. It is a very wonderful coin for which we have to take a single day for fullest explanation. Even though he has not meant so. The word is so powerful, more than his conceptive derivation. So Stafford Beer, he told that it is effective organization. Then there is Kaufman, Louis Kaufman's theory, whereby he said that it is the interaction between systems of equanimity and equality by which they produce themselves from themselves. That was the description given by Kaufman. He told that they interact with themselves, they produce themselves from themselves. Cybernetics is study of such systems which are interrelated with themselves, which produce themselves from themselves. That is the Kaufman's theory of understanding cybernetics. In cybernetics, there are five major beings which we have to study. The first thing is studying about innate ability. Number one, learning, adoption, cognition or memory power, understanding about social control, emergence, community, various other things that dwell with human beings and human nature and behavior. That is the first level or first grade of study. The second grade of study which we are doing is, instead of boosting our intelligence, somebody boosts the intelligence of machine, and everybody, those who are subservient in intelligence, they are just operators or mute spectators or blind receivers of the benefits of science without indulging much into the innovative study, losing their temper, attitude and diluting the brain structure and brain potence. So the second thing is robotics and artificial intelligence, which is the birth of artificial intelligence and death anniversary of human intelligence. That is the second thing. And third thing is, it is biological. It deals with biological systems. That is bio, biomedical, biosemiotic, semiotic divisions. Now they are going to research on cyborgs, in which there are biosensitive compounds and biosensitive operations in mechanical structures like bioprosthetics, neuroprosthetics, bioprosthetics, innumerable things. Now they are going to blend human beings with machines like cochlear implant, brain port, brain gate, whole body translation, mind import, mind download, brain download, upload, innumerable things. Now they are making in fiction and fallacy. Now they have recently started at the University of Illinois. It is biological computer laboratory. I don't know what harm they are going to bring both to biological creatures as well as computers, or for both. So this is the new area that is going on. Now we are living in the second order cybernetics of Gordon Task. It is the second order cybernetics. Apart from the control and communication systems, apart from the definition that has been given that it is effective organization, I want to define effective organization in Sanskrit. Number one, God has already organized nature, the qualities of human beings, as well as the subsentient, semi-sentient, insentient and infrasentient creatures and systems. First, it has been very supportively made. That is the first level of organization. That is well organized. In second level, you are organizing lot of things on the basis of your want, emergency, expansion, exploitation, population, widening and various things. That is second order. Third order, in order to do all of these things, you are devising tools. You are devising methods, tools, engineering devices. That is the third level. In the fourth level of organization, lot of problematic issues, they have come into rise of their ugly heads. Now we are trying to derive some sort of solutions for that. Now we are in the fourth level. So first is already we are organized. Second, we want to organize something more. Third, we want to organize something for organizing that something more. Number fourth is effective organization, distribution of the same thing without sociological, political, economical barriers. That is the fourth level of organization. These four levels are done by dharma. So, in deeper sense, the exact definition for cybernetics is dharma. He says that it is effective organization, then organized things, already everything is organized. Who has made flowers to have honey and who has made cows to bear milk? Do you mean make that? Are we making these things? Nothing. Everything is well made. We want to make it better. We want to devise more things and we want to distribute the same thing. If everything is done in the pathway of precision and righteousness, that is what dharma and that is what he must have meant. He must have at least thought, or it may be even inconceivable for those people, but certainly it is what we call dharma. Now in the second order of cybernetics, we are dealing with complex systems. That is incomplete, apurna, open, vyakta, indeterminable, aparichedya, then statistical, parisankhika. So all of these various systems are now dealt in second order of cybernetics. They are dealing with innumerable divisions, which we will design and design later. Then the final level is complex systems. There are innumerable systems beyond human thought and perception. Those behaviors, initial behavior, processive behavior, behavior of ultimate. The ultimate behavior of most of the things cannot be recognized by initial observation. Lot of things like genetic crops and genetically modifiable drugs and digital drug systems, they developed and they could not visualize the peril that they have implanted or that are implanted in the devices and their applications in their perceptions. Because in initial behavior, the ultimate of behavior or consequential impact of your initial step will be in a subtle level so that you cannot understand. So understanding complex structures, complex systems, complex theories and complex adaptive system is the recent development of our cybernetics. Then we are coming into informatics. Informatics, you know that there is a system how to deal with informatics. Informatica didactica. What is the pedagogy or what is the didactics of informatics? Information can be passed by any person. But if it is a different term communication, what is the use of information? Information is said to be fruitful if it comes for a fruitful cause from a productive productor as well as a person who is a good receptacle. So, a person who produces or emits that information, he must be sturdy, he must be conceptively sturdy, the information must be productive, and the receptacle, he must also be in a proper method or a proper status by which he can just get the benefit and also make the thing transmitted to the society. So, informatics is not only just sending communications without minding their effect or consequences to society. Proper information, precise information, collected information, useful information, effective and efficacious methodology of implementing that tool so that it reaches lot of people for lot of benefit for lot of periods. So that which is crossing the time frame, that which is within the benefit frame, that which enframes all members of the society for a productive end, that is said to be a real information system. So in informatics, you know that we are having innumerable information system now. We're starting with education. There is a teleinformatics in which distant learning now they are teaching through satellite communication, then e-learning and various things there. Even with the book, with their master to teach, they are not learning. How they will make EF and G-learning, they don't know. It is an additional source of knowledge for people, those who are having courage, those who are having confidence, those who are having commitment, those who are having untiring, unquenchable zeal for mastering the wisdom. For them, even a blank paper will contribute all meanings. If a person has no such qualities, even your printed encyclopedia will be just a pillow for them, just to keep them clean. So, informatics starts with the embryo of the mother. It is known as embryonic informatics or embryo informatics, in which the subtle instincts, impressions, imprints of the mother that has been genetically, environmentally, individually, collectively implanted, transplanted and proplanted by her thought, speech and action to the embryonic field that makes the child to learn. I used to call it as intrauterinal academy, in which uterus is the first academy of learning. So it starts with that. Now you are having in school knowledge structure, exercise classing, then exploration modules, K-12, distant learning, effective learning, no learning, close your books, innumerable things, novel things that they are now producing just to attract people. But they are not implanting the basic criteria. You can cook anything, but how to cook without fire? The fire is the zeal from a student, that is the impartial zeal from a master, that is a receptive zeal from a student, that is a vibrant zeal from the environment, the learning environment, from the academy, that is the work of a government, that is the work of an academy, that is the work of a parent, that is the work of an individual, that is the work of a teacher. So innumerable people, they have to totally federate for a common purpose of implanting the realistic, fruitful, rejoiceable wisdom in the society. Informatics is there everywhere. And what is the use of the information if nothing is properly done? That is bioinformatics, geoinformatics, cryptoinformatics, nanoinformatics, neuroinformatics, innumerable informatics are there. What is the use of these things? So basically now recently, like this Olympiad, there are only three games. One is an active dynamic game. Second is a creative dynamic game. Third is a recreative dynamic game. Recreative dynamism is media for which there is Oscar Award. Creative dynamism is science for which there is Nobel Award for peace, literature and something that is creative for the society. For active dynamic activities like athletics, etc., there is Olympics. And now recently at Cairo 2008, International Olympiads in Informatics was conducted with gold medal, silver medal, bronze medal, exclusively in informatics. Likewise in cybernetics, in various other divisions, that is also very much essential, that is active. But certainly for creative dimensions and dynamism of the society, we should organize such things. Coming to the conclusive session of this lecture, I want to just underline few points to take it to the action from today. In the succeeding conferences, in succeeding inferences, in succeeding preferences in all of your actions. Number one, systemics is the seed understanding of the systems, that is a seed. And that seed is very portable, very easy. And if you understand the system, you can master any art. By mastering the art only, they are trained to understand the system nowadays in school. Without understanding the system, due to compulsion, due to imitation of others, or due to its social returns in the form of occupation and other benefits, they are driven by a talentless motion and notion towards education, by which they don't relish and understand. By a coercive suppression, they are forced to write something or to say something which they don't know what they are doing, even after a few seconds after completing the task. So, this type of relishing that starts only from understanding. Systemics must be included. Now, recently, they have included ontology in all subjects. Because they have found out, instead of taking this circumlocutive motion or circumlocutive process by which they have to understand the ontology starting from a grain step, now they have understood not even a grain of knowledge is accessible without understanding the ontology. That's what they have derived in the past 5 decades of knowledge pursuit. So, systemics is like a seed, it encompasses everything. Second is cybernetics, it is like a broad tree. It can give you comfortable shelter and shadow. Then the third thing is the fruit of the tree, which is the informatics. That is the active portion, that is the dynamic portion of the science. So we have to understand this trinity, the holy trinity. Likewise, it is the technical trinity of modern science. And number two, role of incumbents. All philosophers as well as the social scientists, they are bothered about that. What is role of incumbents or rule of incumbents? Whenever a person derives something, I have already told, just indicated. Whenever a person derives something, brain has 3 powers. One, to understand your problem, to solve your problem. Third thing is to create a system which can solve the problem. Understanding about the problem is known as cognition. To solve the same problem by its own power is metacognition. Third thing, to create a system to solve your problem is science and technology. By more science and technology, its understandability as well as self-settlement, that progress that is there within that system, that is being diluted. This is a role and rule of incumbents that has made people to be just imitators, that is copycats, imitators, adapters, and operators of mechanisms, more inventors, more innovators, our self-settlement issues have been totally dropped back. That is rule of incumbents. Then third thing is, cybernetics, there is also social cybernetics. Apart from this, there is social cybernetics also. They are concerned about the society also, I already told. The society has 3 things. One is caliber of a person, acumen of a person, and aptitude of a person. These 3 things must be properly boosted. If unwanted things are there, they must be rectified, and proper identification, channelization must be brought, either by an individual, or by a system, or by an institute, or by way of adoption, of voluntary decision and submission. It must come in the society. That is the second thing. The third thing is, man-man interface must be there. Now we are studying about man-machine interface and interaction. Is there proper interaction between man and man of the same community, same language within the same border? You need not bother about extra-border terrorism, cross-border terrorism, transnational terrorism, transnational non-fraternity, all of these things you throw away. Is there any fraternity? That's what I told in the same seminar 2004. It is very difficult to maintain brotherhood with your own brother. Then only we can think about other brothers, thinking them as brothers is secondary. So, it should also deal with a neural sterilization for all people by which the mind or the brain does not drive the person or tempt a person to go against the pathway of harmony, peace and interrelativity. For mutual benefit, for perennial benefit, for long-term benefit, it must be there. And finally, as we are discussing with Bakkerji, the fourth point is, this CT must rule IT, BT and NT. Cognitive technology must parallelly, coherently, collaterally succeed with biotechnology, nanotechnology, neurotechnology and information technology. If it is totally unguided, uncared for it, cognitive technology or cognizant development. Cognizant is not the name of any company. It may be the name of company. I am mentioning the real Cognizant mode in which the person utilizes his knowledge, relishes his knowledge for understanding, effective application and forceful distribution to all needed members, deserving and desirous as well as dynamic members of the society. This must come now. For which we have to create, like we have to create an institute of intuitionistic logic tomorrow. Likewise, there must be like American Institute of Cybernetics, there must be an institute for social cybernetics and this cognitive cybernetics must collaterally, parallelly travel with all emerging sciences in order to make the science really a science, not a vision. So to authorize the science, there must be a system in which we must concentrate on three issues. And Mr. Patelji has spoken about food, food production, food security, food itself. There are only three things. The first medicine is inside your body, homeostasis. If anybody loses that homeostasis, they have to be dependent on food and nutrition supplements. Any person having his own healing inside is known as Uttama, the superior. Any person dependent on food habits and regulation is Madhyama or mediocre. Any person drug consuming is Adhama or inferior. So food is drug, food is life. If food is taken with proper nutrition balance, it supports your survival, number one. If it is taken with extra supplementary nutrition, it is a drug, it saves you from diseases. If it is taken after divine offering, it is prasada, that gives you knowledge, that gives you realization, devotion, dedication and liberation. So food is everything, that's why we say annam brahma. That type of food which we conceive in our land is the Brahman, it is the Supreme God. Even the Tata people, they used to mix their drugs. Even poison, it will be mixed with food, and it has been given in lovely royal stories. You must have heard of these things. So, that is mind control drugs, mind diverting drugs, poisonous drugs, innumerable things. We have seen them being mixed and given in royal banquets. Likewise, we can give a spiritual feast in which knowledge is mixed, truth is mixed, honesty is mixed, service orientedness is mixed in the prasad and distributed to each and everybody in their homes, in congregations and festivals. So, food is everything. So, three major divisions of the social cybernetics. First, we should contemplate on food, food quality development, food internal quality development, food productivity, food distribution, food analytical study, nutritional vigilance and proper guidance, and a system of food security that should be developed, number one. Number two, pollution control. We must try to implant knowledge in restricting future pollutions, in subsidizing the already available contribution. I told in the seminar, for 400 billion tons of carbon dioxide is the contribution of the industrial revolution to the globe. Likewise, we have to mitigate the pollution, and we have to totally extirpate the pollution impact that already we have contributed to our mother globe with a lot of gratitude and affinity and affection. Already we have done the maximum possibility damage that we can do, that we have to take care. Third thing is security. Information security, economic security, social security, political security, internal security, cross-border, transnational security. So based on security issues, food issues, as well as pollution mitigation, we have to start a new institute at all. And also I want to say, the compatibility or comparability of this informatics, systemics and cybernetics to national development. If you take the nation as a system, our nation, our country as a system, then this nation is systemics. Then the interactive behavior of the citizen of a nation, nation's interaction with us, she has given us land to live, she has given us resources, she has taken care of us. Our interaction is in the form of patriotism, that is cybernetics. Then informatics is the practical way of executing our patriotism by means of sincerity, one, systematization, number two, then service, number three, triple S. So our nation is the system, and our cybernetic interactive reflexive repayment or reimbursement of our gratitude is in the form of patriotism, which should be shown by an informative way of productive transmission through our sincerity, systematization and service. And this is what we call science. I have to give a new definition for science. S for systematics, C for cybernetics and I for informatics. And if these three things are E, educated, established and empowered for nano level and cosmic ethics, that is the real science. There are two levels of ethics. If you are honest, that is a nano level or micro level ethics. If you expect global honesty or widespread magnanimous and manipulative honesty, that is at a cosmic level. But you have to start at your doorstep. Then only you can open the global gates. So, systematics, cybernetics and informatics, educated, empowered and established for the nano level and cosmic ethics is the acronymous explanation. Considering science not as a single word, considering it as an acronym, the expansion of that acronymous encapsulation is systemic cybernetics and informatics empowered, established, and educated for nano level and cosmic ethics. I wish and bless the same thing should happen. Apart from this jubilant occasion of the international conference, today is Vaikuntha Ekadasi. It is a very great auspicious day in the calendar of the Vedic tradition. Today is the day where the doors of the heaven, the doors of the primordial, paramaterial abode of God are open. Let the knowledge gate of the doors of the wisdom should be open, totally gaining independence from extremism, political suppression, social suppression, economical suppression, embracing, bribery, that all these evil forces get out of the science, let science be given independence, its real color, taste and nature, so that it embraces everybody as a bountiful mother. Today is a very happy occasion of Vaikuntha Ekadasi. Likewise, science also, it results in liberation. Maybe not the ultimate liberation, but liberation from niches, liberation from insufficiency, liberation from the struggles of normal and collective life. Let us get that liberation now, and in the same place, the same time, 2004, I delivered the keynote address. After your 5 years program of 5 year plan, now I am here again to deliver the lecture. I wish and bless the institution, participants and the speakers a grand success, provided with longevity and salubrity to do more for the evolution of social cybernetic status in the society, based on which all other evolutions, revolutions and renaissances, they survive on. Narayan, Narayan, Narayan.